Good morning, students. I hope the first chapter was clear to you. Now let us move on to the second chapter, that is linear correlation. Now before starting this chapter, let me explain you what is a correlation. Okay? Now, in many situations, there are simultaneous changes occurring in the two variables. Now there are mainly two reasons that is affecting this changes in the two variables. What are they? The first one is cause and effect relationship, and the second one is changes in the value of the variables due to other factors. Understood? Now let us make it more clear by taking an example. Say for an example, if my expenses increases, okay, so what will happen? My savings decreases, okay. And what if my expenses decreases? My savings will automatically increase. So what is existing here? There is a cause and effect relationship is there. How? Let me explain you. See, due to my expenses increases, this is a cause. My expenses has been increased, then what will the effect on my income? It will automatically decrease. Understood? So there is a cause and effect relationship. Now what happen if my expenses decreases? What happen? My income increases. Okay, sorry, my savings increases. Understood? So here is a, this is an example of cause and effect relationship. Understood? Now the second reason, that is changes in the value of the variable due to other factors. Say for an example, here we are going to have the monsoon season, right? So what happened in the monsoon season? We are going to have the production and sale of raincoats, gumboots, etc. So when the monsoon season arrived, the production and the sale of raincoats and gumboots would automatically increase. Why there is an increase in this production and sale? Because there is the other factor, that is there is an arrival of monsoon season. So this is the other factor that is affecting the production and sale of raincoats and umbrellas. Understood? Now what happen if this monsoon season go away? Okay, so automatically the production and sale will reduce. Understood? So this production increase and decrease, this is affecting due to the other factor, that is the arrival of monsoon season. Understood with the two reasons? That is, first one is cause and effect relationship, and second one is due to the other factors. Okay? So there is a change in the two variables. Okay? Variables, in the first example it was expenses and income. Sorry, expenses and savings. And the second example I said, the production or the sale of raincoats and umbrellas due to the arrival of monsoon season. Understood? Now let us come to the exact definition of this correlation. See, here it is written, if there are simultaneous changes in the value of two variables due to direct or indirect cause or effect, then it is said that there is a correlation between two variables. Say for an example, I said earlier my expenses and my savings. So simultaneous changes occurring in my savings and my expenditure, that is the value of my expenses, a value of my savings. Any changes occurring in the value of two variables, here the two variables are expenditure and savings. Understood? So any changes in the value of my two variables, it could be directly or indirectly. Understood? It is affecting or not, we have to take into consideration that only. Understood? So any indirect or direct cause or effect, then it is said there is a correlation between the two variables. What are the variables in this example? My expenses and my savings. So changes in my expenses would affect my changes in the savings. Understood? It could be direct or indirect. That is no mind. Okay? So any changes in the value of two variables, directly or indirectly, cause or effect, then it is said there is a correlation between the two variables. Understood? I hope it is clear to you. Right? Okay. Now let us understand what are the types of correlation. There are mainly two types of correlation. The first one is the positive correlation and second one is the negative correlation. Now what do you understand by positive correlation? Now positive correlation means when there is a change in the value of the two correlated variables are in the same direction. Understood? Say for an example, if the age of husband increases, the age of wife also increases. Understood? So there is increase in the two variables. That is, the first variable is age of husband. Second variable is age of wife. So both are increasing. Understood? That is moving in the same direction. Now what? Say for another example. If a company's sale increases, the profit would also increase. Now if the sale decreases, the profit would also decrease. So here there is same direction movement, okay, of the two variables. When the sale increases, the profit would also has to be increased. So here the same direction, and when the sale decreases, the profit would also decrease. Understood? So here what you have to study is, then in the positive correlation, the changes are in the same direction. When one variable increases, the other has to be increased, and when variable decreases, the other has to be decreased. Understood? So this is the case of positive correlation. Now what do you understand by negative correlation? It is vice versa of positive correlation. Now in negative correlation, the changes are in the opposite direction. Understood? Say for an example, if a price of a product increases, what would happen? The demand would decrease. Understood? So here one variable, it is increasing, the other is decreasing. So there is an opposite direction of the changes in the value of the variables. Understood? For example, if my expenses increases, what would happen? My savings also decrease. If my expenses decrease, my savings would increase. So here what is there? What is happening? There is an opposite changes happening in this negative correlation. Understood? With this two types, positive and negative. Now in your syllabus, you have to study three methods of correlation. The first one is scatter diagram method. Second one is Carl Pearson, and third one is Pearman's rank correlation method. Now moving to the first method, scatter diagram method. Now what do you understand by scatter diagram method? You have to represent the changes in the value of the correlated variables in a graphical manner. Understood? So whatever the changes occurring in the two variables, you have to represent in a graph. Understood? Now in scatter diagram also, there are mainly five types. What are they? First one is positive correlation, second is negative, third is partially positive, fourth one is partial negative, and fifth one is absence or lack of correlation. Now let us understand more clearly. See, types of correlation in the scatter diagram method. First one is positive, negative, partial positive, partial negative, and absence or the lack of correlation. Now what do you understand by positive correlation? Now in positive correlation, you can see there is an upward direction. See, here there is an upward direction. In positive, it shows the upward direction. So whenever your graph shows the upward direction, you have to understand that your graph is showing a positive correlation between the two variables. You have to see from left to right. Understood? So the changes from here, you have to see. From here, it is moving upwards. That is why it says that there is a positive correlation between the two variables. Now what if your graph shows a downward position? See here, it is showing a downward, the slope is showing downward. Okay, the direction is downward. What it is indicating? It is indicating a negative correlation between the two variables. Understood? Now what if the variables are not showing in a straight line? The graph is not showing in a straight line. What is the difference between positive and partial positive? Is there is a minor difference only, that in positive it shows a straight line. See here, it shows a straight line moving upward. In negative also it is showing a straight line moving downward, but in partial it is not showing in a straight line. So whenever your graph shows like this, that is moving upward. See here, it is moving upwards and here it is moving downwards. So whenever it is showing upward direction but not in a straight line, then you have to understand that the changes in the value of the variables are partially positive. Understood? And when it is showing downward, you have to indicate that there is a partial negative correlation between the two variables. Understood? Now what if the graph shows like this? The points are indicating in the center of your graph. Then now what do you understand by this? It is indicating that there is no relation, that is, there is no correlation between the two variables. Understood? So these were the 5 diagrams of scatter diagram method. Okay, so you have to understand it. Now this would be more clear if we solve a sum. So let us solve a sum. Okay, now let us take one example. The question is, a company manufactures ready-made garments. The monthly advertisement cost in 10 lakh rupees and the sale of garments in crore for the last 6 months are given below. So here the data is given to you. See, here two variables. What are the two variables? Advertisement cost and the sale of garments. So your advertisement cost would be X and sale of garments would be your Y variable. Understood? Now different data has been given. Here 5, it is 20. 8, what is this? 5, 8, 10, it is a 10 lakh rupees. Like this you have to say 50 lakhs, 80 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 12 lakhs and 9 lakhs. Understood? Because it is a advertisement cost is given in the 10 lakhs rupees. Understood? Now the second variable, that is your sale of garments. Now it is given in crore. Like this you have to say 20 crore, 30 crore, 50 crore. But as the numbers are too much, you can't take all the zeros. So you have to take it in short numbers. Understood? That's why it is given in short. Okay? But you have to mention this like this. Okay? In while presenting in your graph. Understood? Now, let us come to the solution. Now, before starting, you have to understand it clearly that your X1, Y1 would be 5 and 20. Like this, you have to write for all the things. Okay? All the years. For X2 and Y2, you are having 8 and 30. Then X3, Y3 would be your 10 and 50. Like this, you have to go on. After writing this, now you have to take the graph and plot it accordingly. Understood? Now let us take the first variable, that is 5 and 20. So this is the graph. Understood? You have to plot Y dash X. Here it is written X and X bar. Okay? Here in the middle, it would be 0. Understood? Now you have to take, see, advertisement cost. Now where you will take it? This is in X axis. So you have to plot the advertisement cost over here. Understood? Now Y axis. On Y axis you would be having your sale of garments. So like this you have to plot 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, like this. Understood? Now your X1, Y1 is 5 and 20. See, your X axis, your 4 and 6 is there. In the between you will having your 5, and Y axis you have to take number 20, like this. See, 5 20. Understood? Like this you have to plot in your graph sheet. Now the next, 8 and 30. Your X2 and Y2 is 8 and 30. So where is the 8? Here is the 8. And where is 30? From Y axis you have to take the 30. Like this you have to move on for the next also. Again I am showing the next one, that is 10 and 50. So where is your 10 on X axis? Here it is. And where is 50 on Y axis? Sorry, it is here. 50. Understood? Understood this? So like this you have to plot for every variables. Understood? Now you have to plot it for the every other items. And now see, is there a straight line forming? See, after plotting every value, see, I have plotted every values. Okay, now what you have to see is it is going in a straight line. Sorry. See here. No. Is it crossing, moving in a straight line? No, the points are up and down. Okay, so this is showing an upward direction. Obviously, it is showing an upward direction, but it is not in a straight line. So what do you understand by this graph? That your graph is showing a partial positive. Understood? So you have to write your decision like this. Partial positive. So this is regarding the partial positive scatter diagram. Now what if these all points come under the same line? Okay, if all the points come in one straight line, then what you have to write your decision as, the graph is showing a positive correlation between these two variables. What are the variables? Advertisement cost and sale of garments. But right now in this situation, the two changes in the value of the two variables, that is advertisement cost and sale of garments, it is showing a partial positive. Understood? Okay, so this was the case of partial positive. Before that, I forgot to say that you have to write the scale also. Like this, x axis, I have taken 1 centimeter is equals to 2, that is 10 lakh. Okay, 20 lakhs. Understood? Like this, you have to take. You have to mention this. This is very important. If you not write this, you are losing your marks. Okay, so you have to be very conscious about this writing. Okay, now y axis, I have taken 1 centimeter is equals to 10 crore. Like this, I have plotted the numbers, then I have plotted the, okay, accordingly with the data has been given, and I have written my decision, that my decision is this graph is showing a partial positive scatter diagram. Okay, partial positive correlation between the two variables. Understood? Okay, now let us calculate the another example. Now, what does it say? To know the relation between monthly expenditure and monthly savings for middle class families, the information regarding expenditure and savings for 5 families is given below. And one more data is given. The monthly income of each family is 20,000 rupees. That is, we are having 5 families data. Okay. For every family, the monthly income is same. That is, rupees 20,000. So, it is very easy to compute further, because if the income is varying, then we can't compute or analyze the data. That's why it is given and made it clear initially. Okay. Now, we are having two variables, monthly expenditure as your x variable and monthly savings as your y variable. Both are given in thousands. Okay, that is, it is saying 15,000, 18,000, 8,000, like this. And for savings also, you are having 5,000, 2,000, 12,000, 10,000, 8,000, like this. Okay, so what you have to start while starting, you have to mention your x1, y1. Okay, so what is your x1, y1 for a family? For the first family, it is 15 and 5. X2, y2, that is expenses and savings for the second family, is 18,000 and 2,000, that is 18 and 2. Like this, you have to mention it in the initial. Okay, in the initially, you have to mention this for every families. Then afterwards, you have to take your graph sheet and plot these data accordingly. Now, how to plot it? See, for the x-axis, we are having expenses. So, I have written over here expenses, and also you have to mention this, okay, that your values are in thousands. Okay, it is very important to mention in the graph sheets. Then you have to write your monthly saving on the y-axis. So, I have written over here monthly saving, also I have written in thousands. It has been written. Okay, now you have to write the scale. What is your scale? I have taken my scale as x axis 1 centimeter is equals to rupees 2, that is 2000. I've mentioned in the bracket that it is in thousands. Okay, so like this. And for y axis, I have written 1 centimeter is equals to 2, again the same. So like this, I have mentioned, see, on my x axis, I have written 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, like this. That is, you have to take 2000, 4000, 6000. Okay, like this, you have to move on. On y axis, the same scale. So I have written 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Like this, I have written. Okay. Now the next step is to plot accordingly for each and every family. So for the first family, that is 15 and 5. So on my x axis, see, I have 14 and 16 over here. So in the middle, I would be having my 15. And on y axis, I have to plot number 5. So here again 4 and 6. So in between, I have my 5. So how would I plot it? Like this, I would go up, and from here it is intersecting at this point. So I have made a mark on it. Okay, now the next, it is 18 and 2. So on my x axis, where is my 18? Here. And where is my 2? On y axis, it is here. So it is intersecting at a point, this. Okay, so here would be my x2 and y2. Now the next, x3 and y3, it is 8 and 12. So where is my 8? It is here. And where is my 12? Over here. So like this. Okay, like this you have to do for the other two families also. Now I have plotted already. Now let us see the points. See, I am highlighting this so that you can make it, so that it is clear to you. Okay, Now, after plotting all these values, what you have to do is join it all the points like this. You have to okay. So what we are getting over here, a single straight line which is moving downwards. Okay, so what this graph would represent? It is representing a negative, okay, negative correlation between the two variables, monthly expenditure and savings are the two variables which are having a negative correlation between these two. So you have to write your decision as it is going down, it is a negative correlation. Understood? You have to write your decision like this. Understood with this negative correlation? Now what if the points doesn't lie on the single straight line? What if the points come like this? It is up and down like this. So what, and it was also indicating downwards. So what you will write your decision in your answer sheets? You have to write it as a partially negative. Understood? In the earlier example we studied, we took the example of partial positive. Understood? Now in this we are having negative correlation because the lines are on a single straight line. That's why it is negative correlation. But what if it is not on the single straight line and it is also showing a downward direction? Then you have to write it as a partial negative correlation between the two variables. What are the two variables? Expenses and savings. Understood? I hope this is clear to you, right?